Hi everyone, and welcome back to the MFT YouTube channel. It's Carolyn here, and I'm dropping by today to share another video tutorial for creating another fun interactive card using the new Double Slider Loop Slots Dynamics. In the past, I've made double slider cards that featured one critter moving left to right and up and down, and it occurred to me that there had to be a way to make two critters come together at the same time. And with the new Double Slider Loop Slots Dynamics, I've managed to figure out how to do this. I can't wait to share it with you all. To create my project, I'm using the 2-2 Trio stamps and coordinating dies, the interactive label stamp set, the double slider loop slots dies, the longest channel die from the surf and turf dies, and the pull tab from the volcano dies. The scene for my critters was created using the take the stage dies, the starry sky horizontal die, the essential fishtail sentiment strips dies, the A2 rectangle stacks set 2 dies, and the square stacks set 1 dies. I'll also be using the new black and white dots 6x6 paper pack, some smooth white cardstock, and some acetate. For my loop, I cut a half inch strip from a heavy duty Ziploc bag that I had in my stash. Hopefully everybody has something like this on hand. I thought it'd be a good idea to share a little bit of the engineering science behind how this mechanism works. I'm using the longest channel die from the Surf and Turf Dynamics. In order for the characters to slide along, it's important to have the loop below the channel. You'll notice that the channel is longer than the slot die, and that's okay because with the partial die cutting technique, you can make the slots as far apart as you need them to be. Just die cut the first slot on the left, then slide the slot die to the other end of the channel, and die cut the right slot, again using the partial die cutting technique. I should also mention that I'll be doing a lot of the ink blending, coloring, and non-mechanism related die cutting off camera in order to focus on showing you this double slider mechanism. I'm inserting the ends of that half inch strip that I made from the baggie through the slots to the back of the panel, and I'll secure the two ends together with my Tim Holtz tiny attacher. I found that this is the best way to secure the ends together, as the loop gets quite a bit of action when you pull on it, so you need something that won't come apart too easily. And two staples seem to really do the trick. Be sure and leave a little bit of slack in your loop to allow it to move freely. Here's a little more science behind how all this works. If you attach your pull tab to the loop on the left side and pull to the right, the front of the loop glides to the left, as I'm demonstrating here. If you attach your pull tab to the loop on the right side and pull to the left, the front of the loop glides to the right. So it makes sense that if the front of the loop is gliding right, then the back of the loop is gliding left, right? This was my light bulb moment. For my project, I wanted my pull tab to be on the right side, so I adhered it to the back of the loop towards the left slot, and again I used two staples from my tiny attacher to secure it. And in case you missed it, I used the pull tab die from the Volcano Dynamics to create my pull tab. And of course I check it to make sure everything is working so far. I created my front panel by die cutting the largest of the dies from the A2 Rectangle Stack Set 2 Dynamics from a piece of smooth white cardstock. I die cut an aperture using the third largest die from the Square Stack Set 1 Dynamics. I wanted to mimic the embossed lines in the curtains from the Take the Stage Dynamics, so I'm scoring the panel every eighth inch using my Score Buddy. And here I trimmed a 1.5 inch by 5.25 inch strip that I'm adhering to the back of the front panel with some foam squares. This piece will become my stage and will also help hide the slider track and loop. Next, I've trimmed two pieces of acetate that measure 1/4 inch by 1.5 inches. This is what I'll attach to the loop and my critters to allow them to glide back and forth. I'm adhering a piece of 1/4 inch double-sided tape to the top of each tab, and then flipping them over and adhering another piece of 1/4 inch double-sided tape to the bottom of the tab. And now I can adhere the tabs to the loop. First, I make sure that my pull tab is pushed as far in as it'll go, and then I peel off the liner paper from the bottom tab of one of the pieces of acetate and adhere it to the far right of the loop, just inside the right opening of the channel. I'll need to adhere the second tab to the back of the loop, placing it to the far left and just inside the left opening of the channel. You'll see that I decided to slip it under the end of the pull tab, but it's adhered to the loop. And then when I flip the panel over, I can push that left acetate tab through the channel to the front of the panel. And now I can adhere my front panel to the mechanism panel using some foam squares. but it's important to not place any adhesive in areas that will impede the loop or the channel. A few foam squares at the top and on the left and right side should be sufficient. And again, I'm checking to make sure everything is working properly. If the acetate tabs move towards the center of the stage when I pull right on the tab, then I did it right. Now I can adhere those cute little dancers from the 2-2 Trio stamp set that I stamped, colored, and die cut off camera. I've removed the liner paper from the acetate tabs, and I'm placing the bear onto the right tab, and the bunny to the left tab. Notice that the critters completely hide the acetate tabs, which adds to the magic of this technique. And when I push on the pull tab, the critters glide in opposite directions behind stage. Isn't that a hoot? Now I can set my stage using the Take the Stage Dynamics. I adhered some black and white dot pattern paper to some smooth white cardstock, and I die cut all of the pieces of the Take the Stage Dynamics. I'm adhering the pieces to the front panel using foam squares, and again making sure that I'm not placing adhesive in places that would impede the movement of the dancers. The two curtains are longer than my image panel, so I'm using my scissors to trim off the excess. And then I can adhere the swags with more foam squares and some liquid adhesive. While I do that, I want to mention that I've created this project to show you all how to make these critters interactive. I personally love to make these kinds of projects and get so excited when I can engineer them with the MFT products that I'm so very blessed to get to work with. What I love the most is when I see you all taking these concepts and techniques and using them with the supplies and products that you have in your crafty stash. These videos are intended to inspire you all to get those products out that you love and have spent your hard-earned money on and put them to use. It makes my heart smile when I see you all using these techniques to make something that brings happiness and joy to someone you love and care about. Okay, we're almost done. I'm adhering the last bits of the curtain with some liquid adhesive, and then I can adhere the sentiment strip that I ink blended, stamped, and die cut off camera with some thin 3D foam squares. And now I can adhere the assembled panel to a smooth white card base with foam squares. And once again, it's important to not place any adhesive in areas that will impede the movement of the critters or the loop mechanism. I only mention this so many times because I'm hoping you'll learn from my mistakes. I can't tell you how many of these projects I've thrown in the trash because I've stuck things to places where they shouldn't be stuck. Just trying to help a sister out. I'm stamping the word pull from the interactive label stamp set onto the end of the tab using some black licorice hybrid ink. And I need one final test to make sure everything is working like the well-oiled machine that I engineered it to be. And it works. I'm not kidding when I tell you my heart skips a beat every time one of these interactive cards works. I so hope you enjoyed watching my video today and that you'll be trying this out for yourself. Be sure and check out the other videos on the MFT YouTube channel for more great content. Until next time, have an awesome day.